Depends how 2015 is.
It wasn't something that I thought that I'd get into. Yes, I had an interest in tattoos stemming from art. So I had, back in those days, I would say it could be like mid 2000s, 2005, 6, 7. I would have like tattoo magazines and stuff. It wasn't as big on social media or YouTube and stuff as it is now. So most of the information that we were looking would have been from like magazines and that. So I'd be looking at magazines and stuff, not really to be a tattoo artist, but I was more interested in the art that I was seeing on people's bodies. So me being an artist myself, you know, that was the draw for me. But I didn't have any aspirations to be a tattoo artist. I was just into it purely from an artistic standpoint. And I really wanted to have more tattoos. Personally, for me, I wanted tattoos. I didn't really care about doing tattoos, even though I was heavily involved in art at the time. So it wasn't until assuming degree in art actually, and dabbling with different mediums. Right? So a medium would basically be, you know, whatever material you use to make the art. You know, so graphite, charcoal, airbrushing, I do digital illustration, all of those things. And I eventually so I went to a tattoo studio to get a tattoo. And when I got there, I started looking at the drawings on the wall, and honestly I wasn't very impressed with what I was seeing. And in my mind I was like, you know, drawing for years, you know, the wood that I'm producing is way above. So why couldn't I do this? Right. Now I had no idea where to get the machine from. I didn't know anything about the machine. I didn't know anything about apprenticeships. I didn't know anything. I didn't have anybody to teach me. I didn't even know where I would get the machine. I just left there that day without a tattoo license, thinking that if I would get my hands on a machine, that somehow I'd be good at this.